Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Please, please, please. It's been way too long, and I'm very happy to be back. Miss you all. I miss doing the show. It's been a minute. Been since the late 90s. So, you know, several decades have passed, obviously. But out of all the decades that have passed, the 2020s is shaping up to be the most entertaining and disturbing. President Biden was in the news recently. I don't know if you've heard this, but he's been coming under fire for possibly plagiarizing his latest Depends endorsement. President Biden believed to have plagiarized his Depends endorsement. Crazy, crazy stuff. The key, the tells that he was plagiarizing his Depends announcement is that he is, in fact, not a grandmother of seven who can watch her grandchildren while water skiing wearing her Depends. It's crazy, crazy stuff. President Biden, not a grandmother of seven who can water ski in Depends. I mean, I'm just as shocked and appalled as you. Anyway, Hunter Biden, the president's troubled son, he's also been in the news recently as a scandal has rocked the White House once again. I don't know if you've heard this, a bag of cocaine has been found in the White House. And it's believed that the last laptop repair shop that Hunter visited was run by Marion Barry. Marion Barry, of course. Yes, if you bring in two laptops, you get one bag of cocaine free. Very good. Hang on a second. I'm being told something by my producer. What is that? What do you mean Marion Barry has been dead for years? You get the hell out of here. Okay. Anywho, what else is going on in the news? You'll appreciate this. I was shopping the other day. I happened to come across the magazine stand to notice that Martha Stewart was on the cover of the Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition. Martha Stewart on the Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition. So that was, you know, interesting. You can see it right here. Troubling, troubling stuff. What's got me really excited is that the July issue of Penthouse is said to have a spicy centerfold with George Wendt. Yeah, George Wendt. Now, I am going to be all over that issue. Gotta race out there. Get that. I can't wait to see those roles in different area codes, if you know what I'm saying. Well, listen, you guys have been great, and we will be right back after these commercial messages with viewer mail.
You're really something.
新発行動採用。キリッと締まって飲み口ドライ。ドライ、ドライ。キリンドライ。新発売。
Jam with the Sneaker Pimps plus Maria Canals. It's Sinbad to the rescue on Vibe.
Tonight at midnight, right after Keenan, only on Fox 40.
Welcome back, welcome back. All right. You know, it's as I said in the monologue, it's been a while since we've been on the air, and we have actually been getting quite a bit of viewer mail since 1998. This is, you know, I think pretty decent for, you know, decades plus right here. And we're not going to have time to go through all of this viewer mail, but I thought we'd at least go start making a little bit of a dent in the pile here, and we'll go through some viewer mail. Mail from my adoring viewers who I appreciate dearly. All right, let's see what this this first letter says here. Dear Noel, did you know that Noel backwards spells Leon, which is the Seneca word for dumbass? Signed, Soleil from Liverpool, New York. Well, thank you for that one, Soleil. We'll put that one, put that one aside. Next up, Dear Noel, happiness is an inside job. That's pretty true. There's some more here. Just like 9/11. For more info, please visit Infowars.com. It's a sign from Charlie from an undisclosed bunker. All right, we'll let that one go there. Dear Noel, shut the up. Signed, Mom. Wow, man, that's very good. We're gonna get something good for Christmas this year. So what else we got here in the pile here? Dear Noel, don't forget to unload the dishwasher or I'm going to beat you with a surgical 2x4, signed your wife, Renee. Okay. All right, I don't really know what a surgical 2x4 is, but that should be interesting to find out. Got another letter right here. Dear Noel, since you're bald, do you use body wash on your head? Signed, Emma from Utah. Well, actually, Emma, this is an interesting one right here. You know, I actually get that question quite a bit. And I have to tell you, what I tend to use right here is a mix of a Bulldog face wash, Ortega thick and smooth taco sauce, and I also add just a pinch of ground cumin. And with this combination, I can guarantee you that your head will be super smooth and you will be irresistible to all the mature quails down at the senior center. So very good, very good. All right, let's see. We got another letter right here. All right, this is from Buford from Minneapolis. Dear Noel, are you that guy from Alvin and the Chipmunks? Actually, no, I am not. But I would love the opportunity to manage a band of small rodents who sing 80s music. So that would be very fun to do. So call me if you are interested in having someone manage your rodent band. Let's see what else we got here. Dear Noel, help, I'm being held captive in a Chinese bakery. Signed, Sumting Wong from Homer, New York. Sorry, Sumting, I don't quite know the location of that bakery. Finally, we have one from Andrew from Toronto. It reads, Dear Noel, what happened to that giant raisin you used to be married to? This is actually a bit of a kind of a difficult topic for me to talk about. If you watch the original set of shows from 1998, you'll know that I was married to a California raisin called Miss Raisin. Sadly, in the early 2000s, she saw the movie Under the Tuscan Sun and felt very empowered, and she left me and ended up joining a cult run by Oprah Winfrey, where then she was eaten by a Stedman as part of a perverse religious ceremony to summon the ghost of Bea Arthur. We dedicate this show to the memory of Miss Raisin, and you'll always have a place in my heart, honey. There's viewer mail, and we will see you with our first guest, Bill Cosby, right after these commercial messages. When I'm tired
and all alone. ポカリスエットがうまいのは細胞を潤すからだ。イオンサプライポカリスエット。
Welcome back. Welcome back. Our first guest is a returning guest. It is Bill Cosby. He is famous for many, many media appearances, but you'll probably know him best from his hit 80s sitcom, The Cosby Show. Let's look at a clip here. Okay, Mr. Cosby, it is great to have you back on the show. Bill, how are you doing?
Well, you know, Noel, I've had some legal troubles since the last time I've been on the show.
Yeah, Bill, I heard about that. Thank you, by the way, for using us as your prison phone call. It really means a lot to us.
Well, you know, Noel, yours is the only show that I'll do. Actually, it's the only show that'll have me on tomorrow.
Well, Bill, you know, you were our first guest, so I thought it would be nice to have you back. You know, Bill, I was watching that opening to the Cosby Show, and, you know, all of the cast was dancing really well, but who stood out particular as a dance fiend to me in that opening was Tempest Bledsoe. Bill, how is she dancing so well in that clip?
Well, you know, Noel, I just decided to slip some ivermectin in her coke, too, and it turned her into an absolute demon on the dance floor.
Wow, Bill, I did not know that ivermectin mixed with coke, too, turns you into an absolute demon on the dance floor.
You know, I'd like to take this opportunity to promote my new flavor of Jell-O pudding.
Wow, Bill, you're still working with Jell-O? That's very cool.
Yes, sir, I'm working with that fellow Logan Paul. We're making a new prime flavor of Jell-O. It's very delicious.
Wow, prime Jell-O. I would love to try that.
Well, you know, Noel, you need to buy it as soon as possible because all proceeds will go to buy my wife Claire a new Thighmaster so she can keep those unsightly thunder thighs in check.
Well, Bill, you're telling me that you're working with Logan Paul to make prime Jell-O to buy your wife Claire a Thighmaster?
Yes, she's going to put it in the new workout room, which we're going to give her after we get that freeloader Theo out of the house. You need to tell that Theo to get out of my house. I don't want him in my house anymore. He's disowned.
All right, Bill, it's okay. I understand that, you know, even though you were once a doctor and your wife Claire is a successful lawyer, you don't want your kids in your house because you need to convert their bedrooms into a workout environment for your wife, Claire, who apparently needs to keep her thunder thighs in check. Well, Bill, thank you for being on the show. We hope to have you back soon. Bill Cosby, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Introducing Nintendo Score 64 and win at Taco Bell. Just peel the coin off the lid, score 64, and you could win an N64 system, cash, or millions of other great prizes. And who knows who'll win the Porsche Boxster. It's score 64 and win, only at Taco Bell.
Welcome back. Our next guest is a guest we've been meaning to have on the show for a while. He is known to be in many, many summer blockbusters. He's also a former governor of California and prominent ramen noodle spokesperson. You might remember him from such commercials as this. Here he is, Arnold Schwarzenegger. So, Arnold, I am thrilled to have you here.
Yeah, this is great to be here.
You know, I've been meaning to have you on the show for a while. Arnold, are there any new projects that you are working on?
Yeah, I'm producing a new Jingle All the Way reboot with Melissa McCarthy and Whoopi Goldberg. It's going to be very empowering for all the ladies.
Wow, Arnold, I hate to say this, but that sounds awful.
After we debut and didn't get all the praise from the critics, you know, it's going to be shown at Guantanamo Bay.
Guantanamo Bay?
You know, there's a nude scene in Whoopi Goldberg and our test show that it's 69% more effective than waterboarding to generate torture confessions.
Okay, Arnold. Very good. So, Arnold, what else is new?
Well, you know, I'm making a new Terminator movie, and, you know, it's going to be very exciting.
Wow, Arnold, a new Terminator movie. I'm very excited about that. So, Arnold, I know you always play a Terminator. Who's the other Terminator going to be?
Well, the other Terminator is going to be Amy Schumer.
Amy Schumer? Arnold, you know, what is it with all these Terminator movies? All the new Terminators are women, right? I mean, I'm not opposed to that, but it would be nice to kind of get back to the series' roots.
What are you talking about? That's Amy Schumer, dude. Yeah, she's a tyke. She's an absolute beast.
Arnold, Amy Schumer isn't a dude. Amy Schumer is a woman.
What?
Yeah, Amy Schumer is a woman.
Yeah, you got to excuse me for a second.
Arnold, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm just throwing up the idea of that Amy Schumer dude. You know, not really being a dude, it's very troubling to me.
Yes. Okay, Arnold, you know, I gotta tell ya, I was really impressed, with your performance in that, ramen noodle commercial.
Yeah, you know, ramen noodles are great.
Arnold, do you have any particularly favorite flavor of ramen noodles, that you like?
You know, it's all good, you know, ramen is phenomenal, you know. You know, as long as it's the decent brand of ramen, you know, it gives you that strength. You know, it's not good for just carrying cars, you know. You know, back in the day, I used to carry my uncle, Ted Kennedy, out of the Al Gore ages. You know, he'd have a little too much to drink, and I'd have to carry him and Barney Frank home. It was phenomenal, yeah.
So, Arnold, you're telling me that you would, you know, eat ramen noodles, and they would give you the power to carry drunk politicians out of Al Gore's scandalous rager parties?
Yeah, it's very good. It's rages, you know, Al Gore. You know, he looks like a robot, but he knows how to get down with the best of them.
Okay. Well, hopefully Al Gore invites me to one of those ragers. And thank you for being on the show, Arnold. We'll be right back with our musical guest, the demon Kogure, also known as Exclamation.
Why did the frog cross the road?
He didn't. We've rebuilt one of the greatest video game heroes of all time, and now he's back. Frogger on CD-ROM. The classic arcade game is back and better than ever, with more graphics, more worlds, more enemies, more superpowers, and it's more addictive than ever. The hardest part is turning it on. Frogger on CD-ROM for PC and PlayStation game console. Revived, rebuilt, and ready to hop.
Hey, buddy. You okay?
Oh. 62% trying to shake up, but the heart's still elementary. 38% refuse to grow up. My brain's like a moving library. Yes, I'm a hero. Bring your race of heroes. Peace and God. Wonderful things, wonderful things, far from my reach. Even in this world, you can feel satisfaction. I need a hero of this. Why not?
I wanna be a happy man. Yes, I'm a
for viewing our show. That was our show for tonight. We'll be back very soon with new and exciting programming on The Knoll Show. See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.